children. You're gonna do an awful lot, okay? All right, so I wanna talk about sumo wrestling. I don't know if any of you have seen sumo wrestling, the big gigantic guys from Japan stomp their feet before they start in order to dispel the evil spirits. We're gonna talk about wrestling. But first, we're gonna do a quick 1 minute summary of Jacob and Esau. Just make sure we're all on the same page. Which Jacob and Esau, twins, right? Esau came out first, Jacob hanging on. Esau, hairy, outdoor kind of guy. Did I say that right? Esau, Jacob, smooth, kind of a bookworm inside. Jacob tricks Esau into giving him all the family treasures and jewels. Jacob tricks his dad into giving him the one and only blessing to be had in the family, and then he has to make like a banana and split, because Esau is like, what? I'm gonna get that guy! I'm gonna kill him! And so Jacob runs. Uncle Laban marries a couple of women, has 7 children, and thinks to himself, after 15 long years, I wanna go home. I want to show everyone everything I've got, so I'm gonna go home. And so, start going home, okay? But the night before, he goes to sleep. He's like one day before going home. And he thinks to himself as he's sleeping, oh my Lord, I don't want to go home anymore. I forgot my brother's there. He said he was gonna whomp my butt. And I know I'm still not gonna go there. And then God starts wrestling with Jacob. Yeah, but you need to go home. And Jacob goes, but I'm scared to death. My big brother's gonna beat me up because everything I did was so rotten, so mean. Yeah, but I saw they're wrestling, like sumo wrestlers. Go home. No, I'm scared. I'll go over there and go home right there. Go home. In the morning, Jacob wakes up and he says, I was just with my God. And I'm going to build this altar, it's to my God. And before he had learned about God from his grandparents, Abraham, Sarah. Before he had learned about God from his parents, Isaac and Rebecca. But that night when he wrestled, it was him and God, mano a mano, shoulder to shoulder. And you're kind of like that too. You've learned about God from your grandparents. Maybe they gave you a baby Bible already. You've learned about God from your parents. They taught you how to pray and took you to church. But you're at the point where soon you're going to go mano a mano with God. You're going to wrestle with God. For example, one night you might be asleep and you hear a thought, a voice, and it's God. You just think it's your conscience. And the conscience says, well, that kid at school gets picked at a lot. Yeah. Go make friends with him. Why? Why should I? I don't pick on him. I'm good. I'm cool. I got my own friends. I don't bother with him. I've got plans for that kid. Go love that kid. Be friends with that kid. No. It will ruin my own status, my own popularity. I don't want to do it. Do it. Sumo wrestling with God. God. All right. I don't want to. Yes, you do. Come on. When you wake up that morning, you must realize that you went mano a mano. Wrestling with God. Doesn't matter if you decide to go be friends with that kid or not. God will be back again. But the key is, you face God person to person. And now you know God. Not through your grandparents, not through your parents. You one-on-one.